Same as everyone else, but without effective empathy? I utilize cognitive empathy to relate and interact with people. I live a normal life. I still work, go to college to study medicine, exercise, have hobbies, listen to music, etc. The media sensationalizes psychopathy a lot, and the typical portrayal is the serial killer, which in reality, are on the extreme end of the spectrum. Psychopathy is on a spectrum, and rare. The vast majority of functional psychopaths are camouflaged in society and are law-abiding citizens. The dysfunctional ones are in prisons. I think they make up 40% of the prison population versus 1 to 3% of the normal population. You'll find psychopaths in every industry and location around the world, and highly concentrated in careers that are in positions of power. My relationships with friends and family appear normal on the outside, but inside, me, there is really no or very little emotional attachment. I really have zero problems in life today. Growing up, though, is a different story. It is easy to feign empathy and compassion with enough practice. For a long time I assumed I was normal, and the people who cried over things were overly dramatic and weird. When people died that I was close to, and I felt nothing, I started to question myself. Thought maybe I was just repressing or something. Saw a therapist and it was eventually clear that I'm just detached from everything that people should be attached to. Doesn't affect my life much. I probably distract myself from life more than the average person. I read a lot of books and stuff. Media sometimes portrays people like me as someone going out and murdering people and feeling no remorse and such. But I've never felt the need to harm anybody. Maybe out of curiosity when I was younger, to see if I would feel bad. But that question has already been answered, so there is no need. Socially, it's odd sometimes. I just stay out of conversations that people get emotional about. I think I have very good opinions about controversial topics like abortion, religion, and politics in general, but my opinions seem to generally upset people. I don't think empathy is necessary to make positive improvements in society. I think it just makes me unbiased and logical. I think people probably like me, because I see people regularly. It's hard to tell though. I don't know why someone would ask to be around me if they didn't want to be around me. I like sports. I have found that I should probably not own pets though. I've had several fish in my life whose lives were rather short-lived, and I would imagine it would end the same for cats and dogs and such. Medication has shown no effect. There's not much to manage anyway. I'm not aggressive. Totally functional in day-to-day existence. In fact, I receive compliments on things like emotional stability, and ability to remain calm in stressful situations. The media does indeed sensationalize the condition to the point where every psychopath is portrayed as a killer. That's fine, but it's as relevant as any fairy story. I'm really not a killer, although murder is always on the menu of options as a solution to any particular problem. But even a psychopath knows that that is an extreme solution, like suicide. It ends the problem, but the planning is endless and the consequences are a pain. Interaction with family and friends is a matter of imitation of what those relationships should look like in order to deliver results. Duty and commitment are fantastic surrogates for love and loyalty. They look the same and can even be better, as duty and commitment can be demonstrated, driving Granny to the store for shopping every week, whereas love and loyalty are things that have to be felt. I can't feel them, but I know what they look like. Bereavement is a good test for you if you're in doubt. I see every loss as a relief, one less dragging ball and chain weighing me down and one less route for exposure. I know the facial expression to wear, but it's more convincing to play the rock, everyone's strength in times of woe and trauma. They think you bury your pain deep and stand as a pillar of strength for everyone around you. You get kudos for standing solid for everyone else. It's the perfect disguise for one who feels absolutely nothing. Basically, just like you do. It's about knowing which mask to put on at any given social interaction. I think psychopaths live much more consciously, for example, thinking before talking. It's hard to find one that will blurt out thoughts, unless there is an ADHD connection. For me, it starts to make the world seem fake. Even though it is I who is the real fake. I am very in tune and will speak to what people want to hear, rather than what they should hear. Also, faking being an extrovert, when in reality I couldn't care less for social interaction, unless there is a purpose that will add value either to my own or those I care about. I think there are a lot of folks out there who show psychopathic behavior, but have not figured out they are psychopaths yet. Either that or societal norms are beginning to erode and this behavior has become semi-acceptable. The one main thing the media pushes is the fact that we cannot show empathy and have a hard time with social interactions. Maybe that is true and I can't speak for others. but in my case I can draw expected empathetic responses from previous social interactions. Social interactions are pretty easy too, because people are very predictable at their core and are very needy. I will normally let the other person divulge as much information as I can take in to formulate and engineer an interaction. Not always for self-gain. Sometimes it may be assisting in the removal of one's ego, or driving a conversation down a more logical, less emotional path. For others, does the above stand true for you? My day-to-day life is actually fairly normal. I wake up, do some work, care for my child. Everything that you would normally see a person do. Obviously, the media does not portray people with any personality disorder correctly. Borderlines are that psychotic ex-girlfriend, don't date them cause as soon as you break up they will kill your next partner. And antisocials are just waiting for you to go to sleep with a knife behind their back, they are smiling sweetly as you eat their poison food. That being said, I have noticed in recent years much more conversation about this and I couldn't be happier with that. I watched the Shane Dawson documentary and people were outraged by how sensationalized it is. ASPD individuals were called gross and people left and right were commenting with things like, "I am glad you think I'm gross," or "Thanks, good to know you find my mom disgusting." It was extremely nice to see. Despite popular belief, we do actually care what people think of us. No one wants to live life alone and isolated. It's the entire reason we try to blend in. And to be honest, the most hurtful thing I have ever done to anyone wasn't physical but emotional. I was also extremely young, being abused by my parents and needed to see someone upset because I didn't feel upset but knew that I should. I have never had a desire to hurt anyone. The main difference comes from my capacity to feel emotion. My emotions are like a level field, however once in a while I will have a peak. It doesn't last long, if I get sad it's over as quickly as it began and often surfaced as just disappointment. I also can feel remorse, not in any capacity that you would understand. I once cheated on a partner and when he found out I was far more upset that he found out and I had to deal with that conversation than I was that he was crying. In fact him crying made me smile. I had to shove his head down into my chest in order to stop him from seeing. I also lack empathy for others, especially stupid people, and I often find it very annoying when others get emotional. I am of the personal belief that empathy and sympathy are two very different things. I can't empathize but I can sympathize. Though I have learned when I am supposed to empathize with others and what the appropriate actions are for those situations. Since you are asking about friends and family, I'll say it's difficult for me to care about people or be relatively close to them, though there are many people that fully believe I am a great friend of theirs. Typically for me to be able to care about someone, a grand gesture of support needs to occur. They need to show me that they care first and even then my caring back just may not happen. For me to keep anyone around, it needs to be useful to me in some way. I see absolutely no point in caring for or entertaining someone who doesn't have something to give me. It is extremely easy for me to write someone off. I do have people that I love, and like I heard this author say in an interview, don't be a love snob. Just because I don't experience love the same way that you do doesn't mean it's not real to me. You may not be able to relate to the way someone with ASPD feels in that regard, but you shouldn't ever diminish them either. Just know that I am sure there are plenty on the side of the spectrum that can't care at all. It's not been my experience. We are not robots. We are humans. Most of my friends and family know about my disorder and I've personally found that if I tell them before they notice something is a little off, they handle it better. It tends to dispel this myth that everyone in our lives are only a plaything and we are just manipulating everything. And while yes, I can be extremely manipulative because I don't get wound up in emotions like everyone else and know how to easily use those emotions to get someone in the direction I want them. It doesn't mean that I am doing it all of the time, in fact I try to do it only when needed. And in fact feeling emotions less than others can also hinder me to grow attached to them. In terms of romantic relations, I personally have only had long-term relationships, though I have struggled with infidelity in the past many years ago. Now I stick to my moral code, and it's much better to control my impulses. Sex is like a high for me, it's the one time that I can feel everything fully and because of that I've decided to only share it with people that I love. Since I can't feel as strongly normally, I figure those emotions should be kept for the one I am in a relationship with. That being said, I've only been in love with one man, though I have tried to love others. No one has presented me with enough challenges to keep me from getting bored and straying, or leaving altogether, except him. Boredom is extremely easy to come by in my experience, and if a partner can't keep me on my toes, it doesn't work out. I will start to push and do things on purpose to upset them, to just feel something. And once that has happened one too many times with forgiveness, I lose all respect for that person. One, my respect is gone. We are pretty much over. you aren't gonna get it back. The thing is though, each person with ASPD is probably gonna give you different answers. Like I said, it's a spectrum and each experiences it in their own way, just like with any other mental health issue. Some people with depression can function and no one knows, and others can't even get out of bed in the morning. It's no different here. I can't think of anything else here, but hopefully you found my answers helpful. It's a minor personality variance on a spectrum. Don't forget they are likely to be normal with everything else. They live normal lives. Often quite successful lives. Stressful situations with life or death decisions are often the most significant to survival, like in medicine or warfighting. It is a useful trait we will not evolve out of our genes. If a person is more disconnected from gore or horrific emotional trauma, they cope for longer. A lack of empathy saves thousands of lives every year, as the more psychopathic individuals have to get the job done, while others sit crying in a corner somewhere. Humanity didn't get anywhere without spilling a little blood. Who better to do it than those with an inbuilt defense against emotional ties? In media, psychopath is a synonym for murderer. A psychopath is more capable of getting away with murder because of the rational thinking and consistent acting. They will be less sorry for what they have done, which leads to longer sentences. However, most murders are caused by extreme emotional states between those who care are irreparably emotionally intertwined. Psychopaths learn to be excellent actors at a very young age. So many performances of emotional care are expected. Here's grandma. Aren't you happy to see grandma? Even as a toddler you can hardly answer truthfully and say no. It's not the done thing, so instead we pretend to be over the moon to see this random old lady we are familiar with, because we have learned, early on, it hurts people's feelings to tell them the truth. If the truth hurts people's complex feelings, it is best avoided. Romantic relationships are doubly hard when you have lost but no emotional ties and have to create a facade of love. It becomes saddening when you see that your acting efforts weren't good enough because they began questioning if you care at all. You'll argue you care just to keep them around, for they are a spark in life, and if you just try a bit harder, you may feel the love you see they have. Family relationships are less strained, as that love can be rationalized as unconditional, so your actions and apparent coldness towards them won't end at all. Token gifts of normal emotional behaviors for good family relationships are doled out to affect some response on occasion, or to meet societal norms. To tell family or partners the truth would crush them. To know you enjoy them but if they just popped out of existence, you'd probably go make a coffee and carry on with your life without shedding a tear. Unless the guilt of not caring breaks you and you cry for that reasons but not for the love, or someone is watching so the act of caring must go on, or what will they think of you? Psychopaths are not emotionless. They feel their emotions for themselves and recognize them in others, but connecting the two is harder. They struggle to see why people carry all this emotional baggage, and they decide to copy along, pretending to carry bags, imitating their gait, posture and speed, lest the normal folk notice they are baggage free and start trying to shove theirs onto you. Is pretending to care when you don't mortal? Is telling others you don't care if they die more mortal? Neither are good options. It's damned if you do or damned if you don't. Instead, the grand act goes on. Pretend to be like everyone else or face up to being very slightly different and effectively be labeled a serial killer, mass murdering sadist, because you are carefree, truly independent and capable of anything. I am undiagnosed but pretty sure at the very least a sociopath. To answer your questions, my life is pretty normal, except that I don't have real friends of my own, I don't feel the need to be close to anyone, but I have sort of been adopted by my wife's friend's circle. When it comes to my wife and daughter, I tell them I love them every day, several times a day. I do all I can to look after them, and if you ask my wife, she will tell you that I fulfill her every need even before she knows she needed something. Deep down though, I know that if she said to me tomorrow that she met someone new and want to move on, I would not for a second cause drama or try to stop her. I don't have feelings about people dying, I wouldn't hurt anyone, I believe humanity needs to live in harmony for growth and preservation, death is part of life. As some others have said, I keep a cool head during stressful times and can take calculated reactions when other people go into panic. When it comes to friends, I don't have any type of attachment to people, hence not having my own friends. I do feel that I am doing something right when I see my wife and daughter happy, so I guess I have some sort of empathy. I generally treat people with respect, I don't like bullies or people being mean to each other.